Youth camp season is in full swing. This week, the Clay football program had close to 70 kids out. They heard from Bruce Gradkowski earlier this week, and another special guest tonight, former Eagle Jordan Kovacs. After walking on at Michigan, Kovacs went on to be named a Wolverine captain as well as the 2012 Michigan team MVP. After a couple of years in the NFL, Kovacs is beginning his second season as a grad assistant in Ann Arbor. After he talked to the campers, Kovacs spent some time with us, admitting it didn't take much arm twisting from Clay head coach John Gallius to spend some time with the future Eagles.
No, you know, I was eager, and he, you know, as soon as he was hired last year, all I could think was, how can I be, you know, maybe a small part, but just to get back out here and be a part of the program was, it's an awesome opportunity, and, you know, Coach Gallius is doing phenomenal things, and, you know, the program's on the up and up, so it's awesome to be back out here.
Talking to the kids, one of the things you kept on talking about was being a tough guy. Obviously, you were a tough guy as a player, and you've taken that mentality onto the next stage of your career.
Yeah, you know, I think toughness gets you a lot of, you know, it gets you a lot of different places in this world. And for me, football-wise, it paid dividends to be tough. I wasn't gifted athletically, but, you know, I just had to be tough and to stick with it and not give up. And I think that those things, you know, hold true throughout the rest of your life as well.
You also touched on the fact that track in high school paid dividends for you. We hear so much about multi-sport guys, and I can't understand who in their right mind this day and age says to only play one sport. We have so much information that says playing multiple sports is a benefit for the athlete.
Yeah, I mean, being a multi-sport athlete was the best thing that I did in high school. And, you know, it's funny, I was just talking to Coach Waymer, who's coaching soccer out here now, but he was my track coach in high school. And I told him point blank that being a track athlete was probably the best thing I did for my football career, where, you know, I learned how to push myself physically and mentally as well. And, you know, so when I did make that leap to the next level, I knew how to condition and I knew how to do those things that maybe the rest of the guys weren't doing.
As you are a grad assistant now with Michigan, do you see coaching as your full-time profession once you get through school?
I sure as hell hope so. I like it. I love coaching, and you know, I hope that, you know, I can continue down that path. But you know, it's just been such a pleasure to be back within the program, be coaching, and just to be around the guys. It's been great.
One of the things you focus on with the Wolverines is the defense. Obviously, that's where you played, but the defensive line, it looks like you've got a makings of one of the special defensive lines, not only in the Big Ten, but in the country.
Yeah, you know, we've got talent. You know, we got a lot of guys back from last year. We lost Mo Hurst, who's going to be a big loss, but we've got the talent. And the guys seem eager, they seem hungry, but you never know until day one of football camp, and then you really never know until, you know, we get under the lights September 1st how they're really going to react. But, you know, from what they did last year, we're excited about the future, and we do think we have a pretty good defensive line.
I'm pretty sure college football fans are counting down the days right now. We're getting closer. Is the eagerness, the excitement shared by the coaching staff?
No doubt. You know, as a coaching staff, you really start talking about it in spring ball. Like, I can't wait. I can't wait till September 1st. I can't wait for, you know, or I can't wait for training camp to start. But it's just such a waiting game. It's such a tease. But we're excited. We're getting really close, and we're almost there. So I know we report the 25th as a coaching staff, and I think that we really report August 3rd as players. And I know that Don Brown and Greg Madison, they can't wait to get out there. So I'm right there with them.
Eagles on three. One, two, three, eight.